storm with winds of 140 miles per hour, gust of 165, moving to the west-northwest at 17 miles per hour. This storm is very strong, it is very symmetrical, and it is going to cause destruction.
More than a million people are being told right now to get out because of this. What you're looking at right now is a satellite image of the eve of Hurricane Florence, a potentially devastating Category 4 hurricane approaching the southeastern coast. Now, from space, you can see what a monster storm this really is as it picks up strength and heads for coastal areas in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Virginia. Take a look at this incredible video, the eye of Hurricane Florence. Now, imagine flying a plane right into that massive Category 4 storm. Maximum winds 140 miles per hour. That's what my next guest did. He's monitoring the storm as it takes aim at the Carolinas, where about a million people have been ordered to evacuate.
Well, from our flight today, we learned that Florence is getting stronger and stronger by the minute, and it's truly turning into a beast of a storm. Went from a tropical storm to a major hurricane in a matter of 72 hours. So it's what they call rapid intensification. So the storm has really got its act together.
Producing pretty widespread surf in the waist to chest high zone for Central and Northern Florida. Even some bigger sets in Central Florida and those typical standouts up in North Florida, like New Smyrna Beach. Further south, we got a report from Jonathan Warren that surf along the northern parts of the Treasure Coast. Smaller than that in the knee to waist high zone, and even smaller as you get down into the Bahamas shadow there. Winds have come light on shore, but still pretty fun conditions out there, all things considered. And that actually looks like one of the potentially better spots as we head later in the week. It looks like solid increase in swell for Florida. As Florence eventually makes landfall and that fetch kind of shuts down. Condition-wise,